my heart out when the rest of me is down. You enchant me even when you're not around.
Please be seated. Welcome to the wedding of Jason Cruz and Elizabeth Mangaya. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, we thank you for creating these two and then growing them into the man and woman we see before us today. Thank you, God, for drawing them together and bringing them to this day where they stand ready to be wed as husband and wife. Bless this union, strengthen it, protect it, and use it for your glory. Amen. We've gathered together today as friends and family in the sight of God to unite Jason and Elizabeth in holy matrimony. Webster's dictionary tells us that marriage is the legal joining of a man and a woman into a close union as husband and wife. That definition, as accurate as it is, doesn't give us the whole picture in regards to marriage. Fortunately for us, God in his word sheds much light on this most remarkable of subjects. For this cause, God said man would leave his mother and father and be joined to his wife, and the two would become one flesh. You see, Jason, in the beginning, when God first created man, he recognized that by himself man would never be complete. It was God that said it's not good that man should be alone. So he created the woman in order that there might be completeness, companionship, and love. God then brought her to Adam, and she became his wife. So in a sense, God not only ordained marriage, but he actually planned the first wedding ceremony, and then he presided over the whole occasion. 1 Corinthians 13 gives us a good picture of the type of love you should strive to have for one another as husband and wife. It says, love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered, and it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. Emmett Fox said this about marriage: there is no difficulty that enough love will not conquer, no disease that enough love will not heal, no door that enough love will not bridge, no wall that enough love will not throw down, no sin that enough love will not redeem. It makes no difference how deeply seated may be the trouble, how hopeless the outlook, how muddled the tangle, how great the mistake. A sufficient realization of love will dissolve it all. If only you could love enough, you could be the happiest being in the world. Jason and Elizabeth, real love can bring you through anything. At this time, a rose will be placed on the chair of Arsenio Cruz in his honor. Elizabeth, please face Jason and hold his hands, palms up, so you could see the gift that they are to you. These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and vibrant with love, holding yours on your wedding day, as he promises to love you all the days of his life. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future, as you laugh and cry and share your innermost secrets and dreams. They are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years for a lifetime of happiness. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. They are the hands that will comfort you in illness and hold you when fear or grief fill your mind. These are the hands that will tenderly lift your chin and brush your cheek as they raise your face to look into his eyes, eyes filled completely with his overwhelming love and desire for you. Jason, please hold Elizabeth's hands, palms up, so you could see the gift that they are to you. These are the hands of your best friend, smooth, young, and carefree, holding yours on your wedding day. As she pledges her love and commitment to you all the days of her life, these are the hands that will hold each child in tender love, soothing them through illness and hurt, supporting and encouraging them along the way, and then knowing when it is time to let go. They're also the hands that will massage the tension from your neck and your back in the evenings after you both had a long, hard day. No pressure, Elizabeth. These are the hands that will hold you tight as together you struggle through difficult times side by side. They are the hands that will comfort you when you're sick and console you when you're grieving. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years for a lifetime of happiness. These are the hands that will give you support as Elizabeth encourages you to chase down your dreams. Together, as a team, everything you wished for can be realized. Let's pray one more time. God, we do ask that you would bless the hands that you see before you this day. May they always be held by one another. Give them the strength to hold on during the storms of stress or the dark of disillusionment. We ask that you would keep them tender and gentle as they nurture each other in their wondrous love. Help these hands to continue building a relationship that is founded in your grace, rich in caring, and devoted in reaching for your perfection. May Jason and Elizabeth see their four hands as healer, protector, shelter, and guide. And we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. And now do you, Jason, take Elizabeth to be your lawfully wedded wife. Will you love her, honor her, and keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keep only unto her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
And do you, Elizabeth, take Jason to be your lawfully wedded husband, to love him, honor him, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep only unto him as long as you both shall live? Jason, please repeat after me. I, Jason.
I, Jason.
Take you, Elizabeth.
Take you, Elizabeth.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
My partner in life.
My partner in life.
And my one true love.
And my one true love.
I will cherish our friendship.
I will cherish our friendship.
And love you today.
And love you today.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
And forever.
And forever.
I will trust you.
I will trust you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
I will laugh with you.
I will laugh with you.
And cry with you.
And cry with you.
I will love you faithfully. I will love you faithfully.
I will love you faithfully.
Through the best and the worst.
Through the best and the worst.
Through the difficult and the easy.
Through the difficult and the easy.
What may come.
What may come.
I will always be there.
I will always be there.
As I have given you my hands to hold.
As I have given you my hands to hold.
So I give you my life to keep.
So I give you my life to keep.
So help me, God.
So help me, God.
Elizabeth, please repeat after me. I, Elizabeth.
I, Elizabeth.
Take you, Jason.
To be my husband,
my partner in life,
and my one true love.
I will cherish our friendship
and love you today,
tomorrow,
and forever.
I will trust you
and honor you.
I will laugh with you
and cry with you.
I will love you faithfully through the best and the worst. Through the difficult and the easy.
What may come,
I will always be there.
As I have given you my hands to hold,
so I give you my life to keep. So help me, God. May I have the rings? Our bride and groom will now confirm their vows by the giving of a ring, the token and pledge of their love and allegiance to one another. Just as the rings have no end, but they go on and on, so should your love have no end, and it too should go on and on. As the rings are often made of gold, which symbolizes purity, may your marriage be one of purity, where you keep only to one another in the marriage. Then years from now, as you look down at your hand and you see the ring, may it serve to remind you of this moment as you stood right here before God, friends, and family, with your promise to love. Please place that on your bride's hand and repeat after me. Elizabeth,
Elizabeth.
Today we move
from I to we.
Wear this ring
as a symbol of our decision
to join our lives together.
To join our lives together.
With this ring,
I pledge myself to you.
With all the affections of my heart.
With all the affections of my heart.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Let's place that on your groom's hand. Repeat after me. Jason.
Today we move.
From I to we.
Wear this ring.
As a symbol of our decision.
To join our lives together.
With this ring.
I pledge myself to you.
With all the affections of my heart.
As long as we both shall live.
Thank you. Our bride and groom will now partake in a unity sand ceremony. In just a moment, they will approach the table behind me, take the two smaller vials of sand and pour them into the larger vial in the center of the table, symbolizing their two individual lives joined together as one here today. Well, I wanted to keep the ceremony nice and short, so I attempted to convince Jason to skip the next part of the ceremony, the kissing of the bride. But as you can imagine, he was strongly determined that we not leave that part out. So he argued with me, we bantered back and forth, I eventually gave in, and I'm happy to say to you now, Jason, you may kiss your bride. And now I have the honor of being the first ever to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Jason Cruz.